The next solution I'll propose is the strength of a One Africa. So those who know, I always say, like, it's a numbers game. The numbers game is in terms of voices, a numbers game in terms of purchasing power, a numbers game in terms of money. But our whole numbers game, bargaining, and our ability to influence certain things is very weak when we are scattered all over the place. But there's a huge strength and potential in the One Africa movement, knowing that America is strong today because the world has to buy petrol in the dollar. Imagine that Africa has the petrol, and then we have lots of other natural resources that the whole world needs and wants. If there is one currency in Africa and the whole world has to demand that currency to buy all of these resources, you don't have to fight to make that currency the strongest. It just becomes the strongest. Look at Africa's youthful population. If they have to be united with one voice, and then this youthful population grows into a middle class, a good, educated, and productive middle class, the purchasing power of Africa will be rivaled by none. The productive power of Africa will be rivaled by none. So when we are divided, and then we want to go and fight certain fights divided, we have already lost. I'm not going for nothing, no losing battle, my man. I'd rather read, talk on YouTube, eat some food and sleep, rather than knowing that I'm going to lose but still going to fight. At least let me have some logical things that I can even deceive myself that we can win or we might win. They cannot be obvious in front of me. So even my morale will be low because I know that I'm just going to die. I can as well just drink some poison and sleep.
Yeah, Kwame Nkrumah, actually, I'm talking about Kwame Nkrumah from Ghana, and his endeavors to have a Pan-African society and the surrounding... One Africa. So, and you had a lot of these oppositions to that at that time, and when you look at a lot of people who were opposing, they were mostly the leaders at the time, because I feel like a lot of them were looking at the individual benefits they have instead of the what benefits do we have as a people, and looking at the short-term benefits they will have. Like, yeah. But when you always look at these visionary leaders, these leaders who want, like, the best for Africa, if you listen to the man from Rwanda, the president of Rwanda, Kagame, right?
Kagame.
So this is, you listen to some of his talks, he also talks about Africa uniting, Africa coming together. So what I'm saying is, most of the times when you listen to leaders, visionaries who think of how can we, Africa, step up and be at the same level with the other continents in the world, have the same bargaining power, how can we step up, they all see this power, the power in unifying Africa. So, like, this One Africa is not just something you are seeing today, it's not just something people are saying today, it's not just something Carl De Niro or King B or whoever is saying, it's something that people who have studied, analyzed, and know what it takes to get Africa to the top, they all know that in order for Africa to get to that level, we all need to come together and be one.